thing.
Is it time?
So what did they give him?
Paxlovid. It's when you get diagnosed with that, they, if you're old, they recommend it. So.
Okay.
Yeah. And Penny, thank you for your note. You spoke grace to me. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Oh, no,
good morning, Zoomers. It's wonderful to see you all here today. It's wonderful to see those of you in the congregation, too. We have a visitor, and I'm sure you met him last week. Ross is back there. He came back, so he must appreciate us, and that is always great. So good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, dear. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, that's the way. It's wonderful to see you this day, as always. I don't think we have birthdays today, so we didn't get to sing the birthday song. We have Dale with us today, which is wonderful. So we, our musicians are Gary, Jerry, Dennis, and Dale. Our worship leaders, our assisting minister is Sandra. Reader is Andrea. I don't know if she's here. You're the reader? You don't look like Andrea, though. Okay, that's wonderful because we need you. Good job. I don't know. Maybe I don't have the right list. Who? Bev was, no. Bev's reader? We have so many readers. I must have the wrong list. Bev is the reader. I'm sorry, Darcy. You're just doing an announcement. We are really organized. It's probably my fault as usual. No. You probably sent it and I didn't see it. Well, see, then it is my fault. But that's why I've been wrong two times in a row. So, oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, this will work. We have, you're ready, right? Have you looked at it? Okay, you got a copy. Okay, anyway, I have copies up here too. Oh, I'm so confused now. All right, let's see, what do we have to say? Did you see all the diapers? Darcy's gonna talk about diapers in a few moments. It's exciting to see them start to come in. We have a couple of big Sundays coming up. Next Sunday, October 30th, is Reformation Sunday. I understand that our very own Martin Luther may show up. So this will be fun. We haven't really seen him since the pandemic, so it's great. What color are you supposed to be wearing next Sunday? Red. And Brick and Darcy both have red on. They're prepared. Anyway, I probably told the wrong date. So anyway, November 6th is All Saints Sunday. As of now, I'm not sure. Do you have a list for me, Kay, by any chance, of those we're going to include on the All Saints Sunday candles? No. But you will. Okay. Me too. And so we'll compare. Okay. And if you have a name of a person who has died this past year since last November, please let me know, and we'll include it on our list of people we will be remembering in prayer on next Sunday. No, on the November 6th. All right. As our stewardship drive continues, I'm going to invite Darcy to come forward.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So again, just a reminder about stewardship. One of our missions is to collect the diapers until November 6th. Everybody got pennies? Hopefully we get an email out. Isn't that what we're working on?
I don't know, but I can.
Okay.
Since I know, yes, I mean, I'm sure you told me, but obviously I didn't do it, so I will.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll get an email out and hopefully an attachment, you know, with the date. So November 6th will be the ending date for the diapers. I would like to see the cards come in from the Zoom people. Hi. at the end of this month. So if we could get them emailed to pastor or to the church.
I've received at least one group already.
Oh, so. Good. Wonderful. So it's all coming together. Yay. And we will be presenting the diapers and the cards to the mission during that week after the 6th. So
thank you.
That's our update.
Thank you. Are there any other announcements that, I'm sure. Please come forward. Whoa. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, the Steves. Thank you. It's council meeting next week. Right. All right, are there any other, thank you, Bev. Any other announcements? If not, it's time for a prelude by Gary. So beautiful. Thank you, Gary. We'll continue now with our gathering hymn, Jesus Calls Us, or The Tumult. Please stand as we sing. Are we going to sing the first hymn, Jesus Calls Us, or The Tumult? Oh, true. That would have been smart.
Jesus calls us from the tumult of our lives, the restless sea. Day by day his clear voice sounding, saying, wisdom, follow me. As of old Saint Andrew,
a greeting in peace, followed by the confession. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
We'll continue with the confession. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is eager to forgive and who loves us beyond all days. Amen. Dear friends, together, let us acknowledge our failure to love this world as Jesus does. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that we have a hold on us. We have harmed good creation. We have failed to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Turn us in a new direction. Show us the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. Beloved of God, your sins are forgiven and you are made whole. God points the way to new life in Christ, who meets us on the road. Journey now in God's abiding love through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our hymn of praise is 592, Just As I Am, Without One Plea.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy God, our righteous judge, daily your mercy surprises us with everlasting forgiveness. Strengthen our hope in you and grant that all the peoples of the earth may find their glory in you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. It's time for our readings by, no, is it special music? See, I have it all messed up on my book. That's why, okay, it's time for special music by Jerry and Dennis. Then it's time for readings.
The medley today is a meditation, a bit revival. It's about our hope being in God. Now, some of the language is a little archaic because if you look at it, it's a, I've lost my place, but it's several centuries old, the original, and then a couple centuries later, which is still several centuries ago, it was translated into English, and I found the language a little archaic, but if you read it carefully and understand it, it is a beautiful hymn. And by the way, when we get to Revive Us Again at the end, I think you all know it, so please join in if you feel like it.
Alleluia, thine the glory. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, thine the glory. Revive us again. All my hope on God is founded. He doth still my trust renew. Me through change and chance he guideth, only good and only true. God unknown, he alone calls my heart to be his own. Pride of man and earthly glory, sword and crown betray his trust. What with care and toil he buildeth, tower and temple fall to dust. But God's power, hour by hour, is my temple and my tower. God, great goodness, endureth deep his wisdom passing thought. Splendor, light, and life attend him. Beauty springeth out of naught. Love doth stand at his hand. Joy doth wait on his command. Still from man to God eternal, sacrifice of praise be done. I above all praises praising for the gift of Christ his Son. Christ doth call one and all, ye who follow shall not fall. All glory and praise to the Lamb that was slain, who
has borne all our sins and has cleansed every stain. Alleluia, thine the glory. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, thine the glory. Revive us again. Revive us again. Fill each heart with thy love. May each soul be rekindled with fire from above. Alleluia, thine the glory. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, thine the glory. Revive us again.
Very good. Thank you. Wonderful. You're going to share. That's so pretty. Thank you. Beautiful women.
Here we go. First reading is from Jeremiah chapter 14, verses 7 to 10 and 19 to 22. In a time of drought, the people pray for mercy, repenting of their sins and the sins of their ancestors. They appeal to God to remember the covenant, to show forth God's power, and to heal their land by sending life-giving rain. A reading from Jeremiah. Although our iniquities testify against us, act, O Lord, for your name's sake. Our apostasies indeed are many, and we have sinned against you. O hope of Israel, its Savior in time of trouble, why should you be like a stranger in the land, like a traveler turning aside for the night? Why should you be like someone confused, like a mighty warrior who cannot give help? Yet you, O Lord, are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Do not forsake us. Thus says the Lord concerning this people. Truly they have loved to wander. They have not restrained their feet. Therefore the Lord does not accept them. Now he will remember their iniquity and punish their sins. Have you completely rejected Judah? Does your heart loathe Zion? Why have you struck us down so that there is no healing for us? We look for peace, but find no good for a time of healing. But there is a terror instead. We acknowledge our wickedness, O Lord, the iniquity of our ancestors, for we have sinned against you. Do not spurn us. For your name's sake, do not dishonor your glorious throne. Remember and do not break your covenant with us. Can any idols of the nations bring rain, or can the heavens give showers? Is it not you, O Lord, our God? We set our hope on you, for it is you who can do all this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read responsibly, Psalm 48, verses 1 through 7. How dear to me is your dwelling, O Lord of hosts.
My soul has a desire and longing for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God.
Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest where she lay her young by the side of your altar, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Happy are they who dwell in your house. They will always be praising you.
Happy are the people whose strength is in you, whose hearts are set on the pilgrim's way.
Those who go through the balsam valley and find it a place of springs, for the early rains have covered it with pools of water. And they will climb from height to height, and the God of gods will be seen in Zion.
The second reading, Timothy, 2 Timothy, chapter 4, 6 through 8, and 16 through 18. The conclusion of this letter to a young minister offers a final perspective on the life from one who faced death. Though others let him down, Paul was sure of his faith in the Lord who stood by him and lent him strength. A reading from 2 Timothy. As for me, I am already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight, and I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord righteous God, judge, will give me on the day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. At my first defense, no one came to support, but all deserted me. May it not be counted against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength so that through me the message might be fully proclaimed and all the Gentiles might hear it. So I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil attack and save me for his heavenly kingdom. To him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Bev and Darcy. Oh, that's so beautiful. And now it's time for Dale's special music. We're glad you're here.
Good morning. I come to the garden alone while the dew's still on the roses. The voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. He speaks and the sound of his voice is so sweet, birds hush their sing, the melody that he gave to me is in my heart. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. Me go with a voice of woe,
Thank you.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he's waiting and watching, watching, oh sinner, come home. For the wonderful love he has promised, promise for you and for me. Oh, though we have sinned, he has mercy and pardon. Pardon for you and for me. Sing along. Come home, come home.
It was an appropriate song to sing right before our reading and sermon today, because the key word within the reading and the sermon is sinner, and Jesus is calling us home. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 18th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus also told this parable to some who trusted in themselves that they were righteous, and regarded others with contempt. Two men went up to the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee, standing by himself, was praying thus: God, I thank you that I am not like other people, thieves, rogues, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give a tenth of all my income. But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even look up to heaven, but was beating his breast and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his home justified rather than the other. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
As you just heard, this gospel starts this way. Jesus told this parable to some who trusted in themselves that they were righteous and regarded others with contempt. Two men went to the temple to pray. The first is a Pharisee, religious leader. This man brought attention to himself as he prayed to God. I thank you that I am not like other people, thieves, rogues, and adulterers. And self-righteously, the Pharisee bragged, I fast twice a week. I give a tenth of all my income. When he was finished, the Pharisee was no doubt pleased with himself, feeling the same as when he walked in, no growth, no relief, no change. The second man who prayed was a tax collector, a collaborator with the Roman Empire, and a traitor to his people. Ashamed and downcast, he knew who he was as he stood far off. He prayed only seven words, God be merciful to me, a sinner. Then Jesus ended his story by saying that the sinful tax collector, not the Pharisee, went home justified, and that all who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted. This parable of Jesus may sound simple, as the message is to be humble, but it's more than that. And it's not about praying words like, Lord, I thank you that I am not like that Pharisee or someone else. Instead, it's an honest confession of sins. It's recognizing that we are sinners. Sinner. Most people don't like the word, especially when it's applied to themselves, for we correctly connect the word with bad behavior and shame. Too often the word sinner frightens us away from God rather than drawing us close to him. That's why we forget this important truth. God's judgment is always grace. Grace. Maybe you know someone who has been frightened away from God like that, thinking of his judgment. Long ago in a former parish, a young woman would silently slip up to the balcony to worship after the service had started, is when she'd quietly climb into the balcony, and before communion began, she would just as silently slip away. I never was able to speak to her. Much later, I learned her name was Lorraine. She was alcoholic and lived in a problematic way. I imagine she often was called by the word sinner and thought of herself as the same. But she attended worship every Sunday. From my position of chancel, she'd never make eye contact with me or anyone else, like the tax collector, I'd think. She seemed so far off, ashamed and downcast. Just the same, Lorraine joined in the liturgy and the hymns, the prayers and the confession. Though the title sinner isn't well liked, I don't like it. And some worship commentators say not to use that word. But Jesus didn't shy away from it. Instead, he insisted on it. Jesus insisted that we acknowledge and name ourselves sinner. He also insisted on the healing and cleansing, justifying power of confession and forgiveness, and the grace only God can give. This forgiveness, this life won for us through his life, death, and resurrection. Jesus did that for us. For honest confession means we're telling the truth about ourselves. Through such confession, we recognize we're messed up. That we may have been made in God's image, but we've broken it by our own rebellion and disobedience, broken by sin that can destroy us. To call ourselves sinner is to recognize something more profound than we make mistakes or we've got issues. To call ourselves sinner is to accept that we're truly, utterly lost and bereft. We are.
but for the priceless grace of God. The priceless grace of God, which is his judgment. One surprising thing about Jesus' parable is that the tax collector made his confession all right in the temple. Though knowing it was who he was and what was said about him, he went to the temple. He felt safe to go there. Do you think our church is safe for our messy truth? Would this family of faith hear the truth from that shy worshiper, Lorraine? I sure think so. I know so. But I'm not sure that Lorraine felt that way about that parish that she visited every Sunday, for sadly, she never made a single relationship. Before we leave this parable, did you notice that the tax collector didn't name specific sins that he was confessing? He went much deeper. He called himself a sinner. By that, he named that brokenness at the center of his being, sinner. Some scholars remind us that the original word we translated as sin means missing the mark of God's will for us. Others say sin is the refusal to open up our whole hearts to God and to others. Some say sin is a disconnection or disharmony. Others define it as sin as meaning we break our relationship with God. In fact, that's the best explanation. Sin means we break our relationship to God. And only God's grace can heal this brokenness. What Jesus exposed in the parable was the Pharisees' judgment of others while avoiding his own brokenness, a sin we commit all the time. This parable provides a moment to examine ourselves, and we can discern that when we confess, if we avoid those things that have broken our relationship with God, those things that acknowledge our sin. In truth, this can be really hard to do. Jesus didn't end his parable by saying, "The tax collector went forth and sinned no more." We'll never know if he did anything to deserve God's mercy. And that's the thing. That's the thing. The mercy of God can't be earned. It can only be received, for which all sinners can be grateful. You see, what an honest confession does, it opens us up to receive that grace of God, that grace that makes us whole. Yes, two men went up to the temple to pray. God hears both men's prayers, but only the honest prayer of confession can change a life. Thanks be to God. Amen. Amen. Hymn of the day is "That Priceless Grace." Please stand.
That priceless grace which gave me life. Jesus' life is priceless grace. That priceless grace is life for me. That priceless blood, that priceless blood, that priceless blood was shed. Precious word which brought me light.
Jesus' word is priceless praise. That priceless grace is life for me.
With congregations around the world, we confess our faith in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
In gratitude and humility, let us join together in prayer on behalf of all of God's creation. God of mercy, you are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Inspire your church to serve and love all people with the unceasing grace you extend to us. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of all creation, you formed a world where even the sparrow finds a home. Preserve the beauty and diversity of all creatures with whom we share the earth. Lead us to protect all living things. Hear us, O God.
See us great.
God of peace, you are an ever-present help in time of trouble. Rescue families and nations torn apart by violence and warfare. Unite all people toward common goals of reconciliation and peace for every person. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of hope, you stand with the suffering and give strength. Comfort your people filled with fear or anger, anxiety or shame. Bring healing to all who are sick in body, mind, or spirit. Especially today, we think of Michael Delaney and welcome Kay back to our congregation. Hope she's feeling better. God, hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of restoration, you call us to trust in you and not ourselves alone. Make this congregation a community of humility and repentance, ready to encounter you in love and follow in your ways. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We'd also like to pray for people on our prayers concern list. Members and friends of Calvary, Michael, Nancy, Julie, Robert, Kent and Marcia, Jeff, Susie, Dale and Lee, Penny and Kay. Also members and friends serving in the military, Carrie Egan, the U.S. Army, and our partners in ministry. They are all going through very difficult times now, and we want to keep them in our prayers. Christ Lutheran Church, our Saviors, Emmanuel Lutheran, Lutheran Church of Arcata, Grace Good Shepherd, Reverend Claire S. Burkett, Interim Bishop Sierra Pacific Synod, ELCA Bishop Elizabeth Eaton. God of eternal life, to you be the glory forever. We give you thanks for all who have fought the good fight, finished the race, kept the faith, and now live with you. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. With grateful hearts, we commend our spoken and silent prayers to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Special music by Gary.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Let us pray. Gracious God, in your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make of these gifts a banquet of blessing, and make us ready to share with all in need, through Jesus Christ, who sets a table for all. Amen.
As we prepare to partake in the sacrament of communion, I invite those who are using individual elements to please have them ready, especially those on Zoom. And let us begin together as we make the sign of the cross as these words are said, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy God, breath of life and fire of love, with a mighty wind you brought creation into being, and by a pillar of fire you led your people into freedom. We praise you for the gift of your Spirit, for this. Please lift the bread. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please eat of the bread, body of Christ given for you. Please lift the cup. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please drink of the cup, body of Christ, shed for you. Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and the sending of the Holy and life-giving Spirit, we wait his coming again to renew the face of the earth. Send now your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this meal. Anoint us with your gifts of faith, hope, and love, so with thankful hearts we may be witnesses to your Son. Through him all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The blessing for those who just communed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep you in his grace. Amen. Invitation to those of you about to commune. Christ invites you to this table. We come to taste and see. The table is set. Everyone is welcome.
Oh, on my knees with my face to the rising sun. Oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us bring wine together on our knees. Let us bring wine together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, let us praise God together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising,
please stand. Let us pray. God of abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us sing now our ascending song. What a fellowship, what a joy divine. And that's true about you guys.
What a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Wonderful. We'll continue with the blessing. God, who gives life to all things and frees us from despair, bless you with truth and peace. And may the Holy Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen. Please be seated because we have the postlude yet. Yay, Gary.
Okay, Zoomers, time to unzoom. Go in peace. Make God's love known.
No.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Wonderful job. Good job. Everyone, I kind of messed up a few things, but the rest of it went smoothly. Thank you all for your patience and your kindness. And everyone, like Mike, get well. Renee, don't catch it. And all of you, stay well, and it's good to see you. Have a great week. Love you all.
Love you. Bye.
Let's see if I can do this.